verses 1 through 22. In the land of Oz, there lived a man whose name was Job. This man was blameless and upright, and he feared God and shunned evil. He had 7 sons and 3 daughters, and he owned 7,000 sheep, 3,000 camels, 500 yoke of oxen, 500 donkeys, and a huge number of servants. He was the greatest man among all the people of the East. His sons used to hold feasts in their homes on their birthdays, and they would invite their 3 sisters to eat and drink with them. When a period of feasting had run its course, Job would make arrangements for them to be purified. Early in the morning, he would sacrifice a burnt offering for them, thinking, perhaps my children had sinned and cursed God in their hearts. This was Job's regular custom. One day, the angels came to present themselves before the Lord, and Satan also came with them. The Lord said to Satan, "Where have you come from?" Satan answered the Lord, "From roaming throughout the earth, going back and forth on it." Then the Lord said to Satan, "Have you considered my servant Job? There is no one on earth like him. He is blameless and upright, a man who fears God and shuns evil." "Does Job fear God for nothing?" Satan replied. "Have you not put a hedge around him and his household and everything he has? You have blessed the work of his hands so that his flock and herds are spread throughout the land. But now stretch out your hand and strike everything he has, and he will surely curse you to your face." The Lord said to Satan, "Very well, then, everything he has is in your power. But on the man himself, do not lay a finger." Then Satan went out from the presence of the Lord. One day when Job's sons and daughters were feasting and drinking wine at the oldest brother's house, a messenger came to Job and said, "The oxen were plowing and the donkeys were grazing nearby, and the Sabaeans attacked and made off with them. They put the servants to the sword, and I am the only one who has escaped to tell you." While he was still speaking, another messenger came and said, "The fire of God fell from the heavens and burnt up the sheep and the servants, and I am the only one who has escaped to tell you." While he was still speaking, another messenger came and said, "The Chaldeans have formed 3 raiding parties and swept down on your camels and made off with them. They put the servants to the sword, and I am the only one who has escaped to tell you." While he was still speaking, yet another messenger came and said, "Your sons and daughters were feasting and drinking wine at the oldest brother's house, and when suddenly a mighty wind swept them from the desert and struck the 4 corners of the house, it collapsed on them and they are dead, and I am the only one who has escaped to tell you." At this, Job got up and tore his robe and shaved his head. Then he fell to the ground in worship and said, "Naked I came from my mother's womb, and naked I will depart. The Lord gave, and the Lord has taken away. May the name of the Lord be praised." In all this, Job did not sin by charging God with wrongdoing. Today's memory verse comes from Romans chapter 8, verse 28, and it reads, "And we know that in all things God works for the good of those who love him, who have been called according to his purpose." Now say along with me, Romans chapter 8, verse 28, "And we know that in all things God works for the good of those who love him, who have been called according to his purpose."
In our lesson today, Job didn't discover why he went through the things that he went through, but he did realize that God was in control. We learned in this lesson that God's ways are higher than our ways, and his understanding has no limits. Like Job, we don't know all of the reasons for the things that happen in our life, but we can take comfort in knowing that God is in control, he loves us, and he works for all things for those who believe in him.
We learned that spiritual warfare is real. Satan was allowed to tempt Job into cursing God. Job knew his strength came from the Lord and clung to him during his season of suffering. When we go through troubling times, we may not be able to see the beginning from the end,
but we can take comfort in knowing that God works for the good of those who love him. We also learn that when Job's friend tried to comfort him, it brought him more misery than joy. And when we're attempting to comfort someone, we should put ourselves in their shoes of their situation and think about how we would want to be treated. Now let's move on to the questions. Why was God pleased with Job? Because Job was a blameless servant who honored God and hated evil. Who accused Job of serving God with the blessings that the Lord provided? It was Satan. Satan asked God for permission to do something. What was it? To strike or destroy everything that Job possessed. What was Satan trying to gain from testing Job in this way? He wanted Job to curse God. Did Job fall into Satan's trap and curse God? No. Even though Job lost his wealth, his sons, his daughters, and even got sick, he did not curse God and he did not sin. He honored God.
Hi, welcome to this portion of crafting. Today we have two crafts. One, we're making our own Job story, and the other one we'll be using our hands. But before we begin, let us close our eyes and bow our heads for prayer. Heavenly Father, we thank you for your grace, your mercy, your salvation, your love. God, we pray, God, that you will give us a Job spirit, not to blame God, but God, to be grateful for every test and testimony, because we know that God will bring us through. God, we pray for your protection, God. We pray for the increased knowledge, God. We pray for our parents, God. We pray for ourselves that we will grow closer and closer to you. And it is in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. So let us begin with our first craft. Our first craft is going to look a little bit something like this. And the things that you would need is construction paper, scissors, a glue stick, a Sharpie, or you can use a pen. Now, what you would do is you would take your construction paper and you're gonna fold it like this. So you will have three sections. Then you're gonna smooth it out. Because what we're making is a book. So we can tell our Job story. And then on the front, you're gonna take your Sharpie pen and we're gonna write Job's name. You're gonna put the J on this side and then the B on this side. It's gonna look like this. Then in the middle, you're gonna draw a half C. And it's gonna look like this. Then you can put my, and then again at the bottom we're gonna put story. So we'll draw a half C in the middle, and then we'll put a S, T, then R, Y. So it should look a little something like this. My Job story. And then when you open it up, it's gonna look like a book. Now in Job, we learned that Job had some issues. Job was going through it. Job got sick, he lost his family, and he lost his wealth. So sometimes bad things can happen to good people. But God is always in control, okay? So when you open up your book, it's gonna read before. Job was a very rich man. Job had 7,000 sheep. Job had 3,000 camels. Job had 500 yokes of oxen. He had many servants, he had kids, and he was a very wealthy man. And that was before everything bad had happened. So in the middle, I want you to write, we need to be patient like Job. Never blame God. And we ask ourselves, why do bad things happen to good people? Okay. So we're going to know, as you read the story before, Job lost everything. But after he had a conversation with God and he was restored, Job became very rich. He had double everything that he lost. And he got more children and he lived a long life. So I'm going to tell you my Job story. So before, when I was 16, I got very, very sick and I had to go to the doctor. And the doctor told my mom that I had a disease called SLE lupus. And this year, I got COVID. My whole family got COVID. So why do those things happen to me? Sometimes bad things happen so God can use you as a testimony. And that is how our faith is built up. See, God allowed me to live a healthy life living with lupus. And even though we were not feeling well when everybody in the house got COVID, God cured us and helped us to get back healthy. So that is my Job story. So what is your Job story? Everybody's story is personal. So I want you to make your own Job story. And then once you finish, I want you to share it with someone you love and maybe someone who doesn't know God that very well. So this is what it looks like. Job went through everything bad. And Lady Jackson, she went through everything bad. But then God restored Job and God restored Lady Jackson. I look forward to seeing your crafts. So if you come to church, you can bring it or you can post it on our Facebook page. Now our second craft is this. What you need is the same thing. Glue, a Sharpie, a pen, and scissors. Now what you're going to do, you're going to fold your construction paper in half. Then next, you're going to draw a hand on the front side of your construction paper. Just like this. I already drew my hand. And then you're going to trace out the outline of your hand. Next, we're going to cut it out. And leave a little portion, just like I did here. Just like I did here. And so we're going to cut our hand out. Because we're going to make another book. Okay, when you get to the bottom portion, right here, all right, and then you open up your book. Hi! All right, so then you're gonna cut out two hearts. So just cut out two hearts in any color construction paper that you like, okay? And what we're gonna do is we're gonna take our glue stick and we're gonna put a little glue right down the middle. Then our little baby heart, we're gonna put it right in the middle. So you have a 3D heart. Then We're going to open up our hands. And we're going to put a little glue right in the center. And it should look a little bit something like this. And when you open it up, it's a little something like this. And so we're gonna write something in the inside. Now we learned about Job. So we're gonna close this up and we're gonna put Job's name on here. And we came from Job chapter 1, verses 1 through 22. Then you're going to open it up. Now we know that Job is going to look like this. Job feared God and he shunned evil. So you write that in the middle of your heart. And Job loved God. At this, Job got up and tore his clothes and shaved his head. Then he fell to his feet to worship. You can write that on this side. I love God and I will praise. And you can put little asterisk marks because see, Job really loved God and he was obedient to God. So when all those bad things happened to Job, instead of getting mad at God, he praised God and he worshiped God. And that's how we should do. So I want you to put this on your wall or put it somewhere. Whenever something is bad happening or going on in your life, I want you to remember God still loves us. And even though we're going through something bad, we still should worship and praise God because he is the creator and the maker of our bodies, our mind, and our soul. And one day when it's all over, we're going to be in heaven with God. So let's always love God, let's always praise God, and let's remember that God always will restore people who he loves. So that is the end of our crafting portion. I hope you really enjoyed it, and don't forget to like, subscribe, and share. Bye!